Maybe this is tonight is Laylatul Qadr, Allahu A'lam. As we said last time, Laylatul Qadr is to know the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرَهِ They didn't do, they didn't have the right Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want you all to know the meaning of Qadr, so we want to have it in Arabic always. The highest of level of ta'zeem, of like honor, the highest thing is Qadr. So the highest of a person, for example, status is the Qadr actually. And Allah said that مَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ They didn't have the Qadr of Allah the way it should be. Now the scholar they say الرسول على قدر المرسل The messenger, his Qadr is at the level of the one who sent him. What's the meaning? That the Qadr of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم we cannot even give him his right Qadr. With all the scholars they wrote about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, with all the people who talk about him, with all the description they have, with every Sahaba that he told us about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, his Qadr is much higher than what we even think or what we can imagine. Now, this month we are really lucky because we have this last 10 days and at the same time it's the birth of Rasulullah in April. So we have both because his birth is the mercy for whom? Rahma lil alameen. And if I ask you, what's the alameen? Alameen, what's the alameen? Everything but Allah is the alameen. So all the creation that we know and we don't know is alameen. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah sent him as rahma lil alameen. So for us, in order for us to understand the level of the qadr of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, we can get into his special things that Allah gave to him. Special things that has given to his ummah. So today, inshallah, I want to try to talk about the qadr of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They say, al-ibra bil-khawatim. That means, what counts is the end of anything you are doing. The khatima, the end of it. For example, they say, يبعث المرء على ما مات عليه. You will be resurrected on the status you die. And you die the way you lived your life. So what counts is the moment of death, the khatima, the end of your life, that's what counts. Some people, they described one of the Sahaba that he was with the enemy fighting Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then when they took a break between the fights, he came, he asked, I ask you about Allah. Did Allah send you a messenger? He started asking him, by Allah, and he said, yes. And then he said, okay, I'm going to become Muslim. And he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Rasulullah. And he turned to fight with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he died. So somebody who died without even praying one prayer, and he became shaheed, the highest for us. So what counts is the end of things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to honor human being. So he made the end, the khatam of all messengers, his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he ended this, our existence on earth with the last messenger, the one that Allah loves. And the ummah, who we described that you are the best nations. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. Now we are at the end of Ramadan. So we have to do the maximum because what counts is this. they say ذهب معظم رمضان وبقي أعظم رمضان. They say most of Ramadan went, but became what left is the عظيم of Ramadan, the biggest of Ramadan, the highest of Ramadan, which is now we are in it. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم will put his maximum ibadah in the last 10 days of Ramadan. So the maximum we do ourselves between, you know, our fasting, our praying, our atikaf, our everything, we're getting close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Definitely we cannot be at his level. But the more we get from the maximum of rahmah. The maximum is perfection, kamal. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to, in his normal life, he will most of the night he will be in qiyam. In the ashr akhir, all night, there's no sleep. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The highest, when we pray in front of Allah, we say in qiyam, in tarawih, the highest thing is what? Is when we stand. It's higher than the ruku' and the sujood. Why? Because we are reciting the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While in ruku' and sujood, we are doing our, you know, humiliate ourselves, our ubudiyah. We say we are slave of Allah. We cannot, we are not allowed to recite Quran in ruku' or sujood. So to be close to Allah with love and closeness is when you do sujood, for example. While when you stand and read Quran, this is the highest that we're talking to Allah with the word that Allah gives. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to be like we said last time, وَالرَّكَعَ he did 5.5 juzu. That's reciting the Quran. Now, the Quran, this is the gift that been given to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for all of us. Now, if you read the Quran without wudu, let's say you want to read it from your whatever you memorized, every letter you get how many hasana? 10 hasanat, right? If you have wudu, the scholar they say you get 20. If you pray nafila, you read Quran in nafila, you get 30 hasanat. Every letter, 30 hasanat. The nafila, which is the extra prayer is not the farud. At night, you get 40 hasanat. The farida, you get every letter 70. The nafila in Ramadan is 70. While the farad in Ramadan is 70 multiplied by 70. What an honor we're getting this. We have to really recognize, put in our heart, what's our reaction should be? What should we do? The scholar, they say, in your life you have four different status. The first one, if Allah give you ni'mah, blessing, what should I do? With ni'mah, I do shukr. I thank Allah. Whenever I have any ni'mah, get it used yourself in your life. You have any small ni'mah or big ni'mah, even a cup of water, thank Allah. Then, if something you have tested, it's hardship, sickness, accident, anything happened that really hard on you, what should I do? You have patience, you are patient, sabr. And Allah loves people of sabr. The first one, you do hamd, and Allah loves people of hamd. You do sabr, patient, Allah loves people of patience. The third status is, it happened, somebody commit a sin. What's our status when we do a sin? Tawbah. Immediately make tawbah. Repent to Allah. And Allah loves tawabin. Allah loves people of tawbah. And then the last status in your life will be you're doing an ibadah, obedience. You're praying, you're fasting, giving zakah. They call it shuhud al-minna. That means you recognize that this is coming from whom? From Allah. Nobody else. That Allah allow me to stand in front of him to do two rak'ah extra, two rak'ah or farad. So once you do this, this is why Allah created us. We have this four status, and that's all what we need to do. A lot of people, when they have hardship, they start complaining. They go to somebody, look what happened to me. You know what he's doing? He say, look what Allah did to me. He didn't like what Allah did to him. And they say, why me? Why this? Why that? No, patient. If you want to be higher than sabr, higher than patient, it's called rida. You're pleased. And that's what Rasulullah sallallahu He said, "In lam yakun fi ghadabi alayhi fala ubali." If not angry with me, I don't care. I want you to be pleased with me. I'm pleased with you. Go back now to our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Habibi, Ya Rasulullah. It's been narrated that there is a verse in the Quran. Allah said to Sayyidina Musa, قال يا موسى إني اصطفيتك على الناس برسالاتي وبكلامي فخذ ما آتيتك وكن من الشاكرين. O Musa, I chosen you amongst all human beings برسالاتي with the message I gave you and you talk to me بكلامي. Then take what I gave you. Don't ask for something else. Take what I gave you and thank me for that. So Imam al-Baghawi, in his tafsir, he said this thing that why this verse came when Allah told this Sayyidina Musa. Sayyidina Qatada said that Sayyidina Musa said, Ya Rab, O Allah, I see in the tablet that there is a nation that خير أمت أخرج للناس. It's the best nation we're given to human beings. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. They order good and they prevent evil. يَا رَبِّ اجْعَلْهُمْ أُمَّتِي. يَا اللَّهُ make them my ummah. Allah told them, no. تِلْكَ أُمَّةْ أَحْمَدْ. This is the ummah of our Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then said, يَا رَبِّ I find in the tablet أُمَّةْ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ الْأَوَّلِ وَبِالْكِتَابِ الْآخِرِ وَيُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سُبُلِ الضَّلَالَةِ. I see a nation, they believe in the first book and in the last book, and they fight the Dajjal. Make them my ummah. He said, no, this is the ummah of Ahmad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad. He said, I see a people, ummah, صدقاتهم يأكلونها في بطونهم. Their charity, they eat it themselves. You know, any charity, previous nations, if you read about previous nations, about ummah, in order for Allah to accept their charity, they put it outside their house, and Allah will bring fire from the sky, and it will burn it. That means it's accepted. They cannot eat their sadaqah. Our charity, we give it to other people. We go to, you know, my family member, or my friends, or whoever is poor people, and we eat it. Make them my ummah. He said, no, this is ummah Ahmad. He said, Ya Allah, I see people, if they think to do a hasana, and he didn't do it, he will do it. We'll write it for him one hasana, a good deed. If you think of a good deed, he didn't do it, even do it, we'll write it for him one good deed. And if he did the hasana, you will write it for him 10 times, up to 700 times. Make them my ummah. He said, no, this is the ummah of Ahmad. And then he kept on saying, I see people that their light in their limbs from the wudu. Make them my ummah. Said, make them my ummah Ahmad. Said, Ya Allah, I see people that their book is in their heart. Make them my ummah. He said, no, this is ummah Ahmad. Then it said in the tafsir that Sayyidina Musa nabadh al-alwah. He got angry and he threw the tablet. He said, if you want them, you don't want them to my ummah, make me from ummah Ahmad. Let me from the ummah of the one who gave them all these characteristics. So what do you think Sayyidina Musa want? He want to be in your place. He want to be a member of this ummah. And we get this by ourselves for free. We get this for ourselves by free. SubhanAllah. Look now, Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah described him in the Quran. وكذلك نوري إبراهيم ملكوت السماوات ملكوت السماوات والأرض وليكن الموقن. We show Ibrahim the my kingdoms in the earth and in the seven heavens. While for Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى. He's bypass all the عالم الملك والملكوت والجبروت, bypass all the realms, and he meets Allah. Sayyidina Ibrahim said, وَالَّذِي أَطْمَعُ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَةِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. I have a wish that Allah will forgive me on the day of judgment. What did Allah said to Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ وَيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتُهُ عَلَيْكُ وَيَدِكَ صَرَفُ الْسَخِيمُ. That Allah told him, I already forgive all your sins, that before and after. And I'm going to complete the ni'mah on you, the blessing on you. Sayyidina Ibrahim said, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَمَا يُبَعْتُ. Don't let me down on the day of judgment. For Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah said, يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِي اللَّهُ النَّبِي. Allah on that day will never let down his habib. Sayyidina Ibrahim said, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ. Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِي حَسْبُكَ اللَّهُ. Without Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم asking for anything, he's getting it. He said, Ibrahim said, وَجْعَلْ لِي لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. Let me with people later on, they talk about me in a good way. Raise me. Well, Rasulullah told Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We elevated you already. And anybody mention you, he is elevated. Anybody loves you, he is elevated. Anybody did salah on you, he is elevated. Anybody follow his sunnah, he is elevated. Sayyidina Ibrahim asked, Ya Allah, let me elevate it. He said, no. Sayyidina Ibrahim said, وَاجْدُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنْ نَعْبُدُ الْأَصْنَامِ. Ya Allah, protect me and my children from worshipping idols. While Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ رِجْزَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتُ وَيَطَحْرُكُمْ تَطْفِيرًا. Allah wanted, Allah wish, irada. Allah wanted to take away from any bad things, Riz, the family of the Prophet, not only the Prophet, all the family, that Allah did this. It's been narrated in the hadith من رواية ابن وهب that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah told him, قال الله تعالى سل يا محمد, ask me anything you want. He said, يا رب اتخذت إبراهيم خليلا. He said, إبراهيم, your خليل, your friend. وكلمت موسى تكليما. You talked to موسى. واصطفيت نوح. You chosen نوح. وأعطيت سليمانا ملكا لا ينبغي لأحد من بعده. He gave kingdom, a kingdom that nobody can have like it. The best kingdom on earth is given to Sulaiman. It's like saying, Ya Allah, what's left for me? You gave this and this and this. Then Allah, فقال الله تعالى, ما أعطيتك خير من ذلك. I gave you as much better than everything you mentioned. أعطيتك الكوثر. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. وجعلت اسمك مع اسمي. I put your name with my name. It's been narrated that, before I finish this the hadith, been narrated that Sayyidina Adam, when he ate from the tree, and he, Allah told him, I told you not to eat from the tree, and he ate. And he said, Ya Allah, by Muhammad, forgive me. I asked you, by Muhammad, forgive me. Allah told him, how did you know Muhammad? He said, Ya Allah, when you created me, and you put the soul in me, the first thing I opened my eye, I saw on the throne, your name and there is a name next to you. And I knew you will not put a name next to you except that's the most beloved one to you. I saw on the throne, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And I asked you by him. And he said, you are right, you are forgiven for this. If it is not for him, I will not create you. Let's go back again. وجعلت اسمك مع اسمي ينادى به في جوف السماء. Your name is next to my name and being called everywhere. Everywhere, angels, human being, everywhere they mention you and me. وجعلت الأرض طهورا لك ولأمتك. I made earth pure. It can be used for, تيمم. And it's being made a masjid to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The whole earth is his masjid. وغفرت لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. And I forgive all your sin before and after. فإنك تمشي في الناس مغفورا لك. You go amongst people, walk with them, you are forgiven. Whatever you do, you are forgiven. ولم أصنع ذلك لأحد قبلك. I didn't do anything like this for anybody for you. وجعلت قلوب أمتك مصاحفها. I made their heart is their Quran. وخبأت لك شفاعتك ولم أخبئها لنبي غيرك. And I hide your shafa'ah intercession for the day of judgment. And I didn't do it for any other prophets, only you. صلوا على الحبيب. Imam al-Suyuti, in his book, الخصائص الكبرى, mentioned that ما أوتي نبي معجزة ولا فضيلة إلا ولسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نظيرها أو أعظم منها. There isn't any معجزة, any معجزة, any miracle that any prophet had except you had similar to it or much higher than it. صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد. They mention, they count the خصائص of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the specialties of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they go up almost to 100. So I'm going to go through some of them quickly, fast, inshallah. So we all benefit from, from mentioning this. Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was given the ability to see Sayyidina Jibreel with his actual form. And he filled the horizon. Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, they opened his chest. And they got his heart out. And they cleaned Zamzam with his heart. People in the book, they say they cleaned his heart with Zamzam. But actually, if you know the reality, there are two things. Put it in your mind. Because Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, they said, whenever you hear the talk about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا سمعتم الحديث عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فظنوا الذي هو أهيأ أو الذي هو أعلى أو الذي هو أتقى. Think, whenever you hear about رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, think the highest and the highest of تقوى and the highest of status. Don't raise the bar. So first, earth, when رسول الله was born on earth and his light on earth, Earth found, like, I'm the best. So all the seven heavens, all the, angels, they said, Ya Allah, we need to see this light. We need to see this light. Why? It's only in earth. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to answer your call. I'll bring this light to you. That's why the Isra and Mi'raj happened. In order for Rasulullah go to every sama, every heaven, and his light will shine and all the angelic realms. So that's number one. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show the whole creation, not only the light from outside. Allah wanted to show the inner light. And the inner light is in the best part of a human being, on the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Sayyidina Jibreel opened his heart to show his light to all creation. And they say that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is رحمة للعالمين, is mercy to all creation. In his heart there is رحمة for all the creation. Allah doesn't want to have this rahmah to be given to the devil, to shaitan. So the heart was open and the angel took that portion of rahmah to the devil away so they would not have that rahmah. Definitely from his specialties is the Isra and Mi'raj, we talk about it. He prayed imam with all the prophets. So all the prophets behind him prayed imam actually in during the Isra when they reached Bayt al-Maqdis. His special is also being given the Quran, the seal of all the books. And also that the miracle of the Quran is all his life until now, until the Day of Judgment. This is the miracle that proves that the Quran is the word of Allah. And anybody challenge this, it's a proven miracle. Definitely, he is the seal. As we said, the best thing is the last thing. He is the last prophet, and he's the seal of prophets. Every prophet was sent to a nation, one tribe. Some prophets, they were sent to a few people. They say there is 120,000 prophets. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to all human beings and all the jinn. He is the Rasul to all of them. Now, he was given a treasure, which is the last few verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, and this treasure was given from underneath the throne. It's a treasure. And to know the story of this treasure, you know, a traveler, when he come back home, he bring gifts for him. When he went to the Mi'raj, and he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Ya Allah, I'm going back to my family. I need my gifts, not for you to give them to my ummah. And Allah gave him salah, the five prayers, which is equal to 50 prayers, and gave them the treasure underneath the throne, which is the last verse of the Baqarah and Surah Al-Fatiha. Also, he is the highest number of followers amongst all other prophets. People of paradise, when they enter paradise, there is 120 rows. 120 rows that describe the Rasulullah. Us, our ummah, this ummah, we are 80 rows. So we are 2/3 of Jannah is from this ummah. And 1/3 is all other prophets and all other nations. From the time of Sayyidina Adam until our Prophet ﷺ. Definitely he was forgiven all the sins and he was given the Kawthar. And the Kawthar is definitely, one meaning is Kawthar, that means that Allah gave him a lot. Also it's a river in paradise was given to Rasulullah ﷺ. There is two overflow from paradise, coming out of paradise, to the hawd of Rasulullah ﷺ, to water pool of Rasulullah ﷺ. So actually the water we get, Rasulullah ﷺ will give us to drink is coming from paradise to that hawd. Once you have a sip from this water, you have no harm on you until you enter paradise. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad. His specialty is also Allah gave him angels to fight with him. In Ghazwat Badr, we know 1,000 angels came. We know that one angel is enough to fight, but the angel asked Allah, give us the honor to be with your Habib to fight with them. And they came because they want to get this honor, not because they need the power and so on. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Allah gave him al maqam al mahmud, the status of Hamd. The banner of Hamd, and he made him Ahmad, Muhammad, Mahmud. They say, the scholar, they say, he had like 1,000 names to Rasulullah. 200 names were mentioned in the book Dala'il Khairat. Dala'il Khairat, the book of Salawat, at the beginning of it, he mentioned the names of Rasulullah. There's 200 names there. So he was given المقام المحمود which is الشفاعة العظمى where all the creation go from prophet to prophet help us. They say we can't, I can't do anything. And they get saying Isa we say Jesus will say go to Ahmad. He's forgiven all his sin. They go to Rasulullah and said أنا لا I'm for it. I'm designed for this day. And then he makes a jood. Allah will tell him ask anything you want. And he will ask for all of us. Say ummati ummati. And then he will ask Allah let them pass through the courtyard. Jannah will not. You know, Jannah is a gift from Allah. Allah gave us Jannah, right? He's the owner of Jannah. But Allah gave the keys and the ownership to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He enter whoever he wants. And he stop whoever he wants. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nobody will enter Jannah before me. I'm going to knock on the doors and open the doors. And you know, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jannah, if you enter Jannah before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you allow to see, Jannah will not function. Imagine you have all the equipment, all the lights, everything, but you turn it off. You see nothing. The moment you turn the switch on, the electricity goes and you see all the beautiful decoration, everything you're doing, it's amazing. Same way, the switch for Jannah is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When his face enter Jannah, his light enter, Jannah will give the maximum because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say, for every creation, every act, there is a reward. Allah will reward. So for example, for us, people of Islam, their reward is Jannah, because they did action, their reward is eat, drink, whatever you want, you have a castle, you have gold, whatever you have. Okay, people of Iman, they believe in the unseen. Their reward is the unseen. Because Allah said, فِيهَا مَا لَعِنُوا رَأَتُ وَلَا أَذُونَ سَمَعَتُ وَلَا خَطْرَاقَ الْبَسَرِ. In Jannah, in Paradise, there is nothing you can even think about. So that's the reward. People of Ihsan, that they worship Allah as they see Allah. Their reward is actually seeing Allah. And so on. The reward of Jannah is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like Jannah wanted to get a reward. Is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rahma lil alameen, Allah delayed the punishment of the kuffar until the day of judgment. Because at the time of the prophets, they will be destroyed, you know, all this umam being destroyed. But because of Rasulullah, no punishment on them. Not here, definitely, for non-believer. Also, Rasulullah said, my devil, my shaitan, my qareen, he said, Allah help me. And he said, Aslam. Aslam has two meanings. One meaning is that he became Muslim. Or, I'm safe from him. He cannot whisper to me. Both meanings are valid. Okay? Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, والله it's all for all of us to see the qadr of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is عجيب. Allah said, يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة. Said, يا آدم. He said, يا نوح اهبط بسلام منا. He said, يا إبراهيم صدقت الرؤيا. He said, يا موسى إني أنا الله. He said, يا عيسى يا ابن مريم اذكر نعمتي عليك. And so he took all the, he said, يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة. So when he say يا, hey you come, you know, it's like, يا. But if you want to call somebody with respect, you don't say يا. What did Allah said in the Quran for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? يا أيها النبي, يا أيها الرسول, يا أيها المزمل, يا أيها المدثر. None of the prophets have this except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah made that in the grave, they say there's three questions or one question. All of us, we can have this. Three questions, they say, who's your Lord, what's your deen, and who they say of this man. One question is, the scholar, they say, it's only one thing. Rasulullah will come to you, in front of you, and the angel will say, what do you say of this man? The moment you recognize that he is your prophet, that he's Rasulullah, you know Allah, and you know the Deen of Islam. So your answer is with one answer. You know, the people of love, when they say, what do you say of this man? They say, this is Habibi, he's the one I love. They say, I was waiting for the moment of death, because this is the best moment in my life. Because the best thing, the first thing after I die, I'm going to see Habibi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I'm going to see Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We don't need anything else. The best thing in our life is seeing Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described the highest love of him. He said, "Ashad al-nas hubba," the highest love of me, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, people, they wish to see me on the price of all their family and all their money and all the belongings being taken away from him. It's hard to say, yeah, ya Allah, take all my family and my kids and all my money and I want to see Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But look, in reality, what happened? The angel, instead of taking everything, he will take you from everything. And the moment you take from everything, it happened. You see Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So now, wish this, because it's going to happen. Now, and Allah told him all the future things about, you know, the Dajjal and everything happened and the fitan and so on and so on. Allah made it haram. It's not allowed that anybody will marry his wives. They are our mothers. And Allah let him see paradise and hellfire. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I was in Medina and they made it very hard to go to Rawdah. And I felt like, you know, I want to be in Rawdah next to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And one of the people of Mujawirin, that means always sitting there all his life, he felt that, what I didn't say anything. And he looked at me and he said, Tarif, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam yara min khalfihi kama yara min amamihi. If the Rasulullah sees from his back, the same way he sees from in front. That means we're sitting behind Rasulullah, but not in the Rawdah. That means don't worry, you are under his care. SubhanAllah. So Rasulullah, when he pray, he tells the Sahaba, don't play behind me because I see everything. I mean, some people they move, they do this and this, you know. No, be, you know, in calm because I see you. He was giving Jawami al-Kalim. He was giving the best talk. Two words will give you meanings and meanings. Wallahi, there is scholar that wrote books on the words of Rasulullah, Jawami al-Kalim. They gathered, you know, all the meanings in one word or two words, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was given the keys of all treasures of earth. He could have been, you know, but he doesn't want to have it. He said, no, I don't want it. He was given sharh al-sadr, that means expansion of his chest. He can handle anything. He can have patience of anything. You know what's the highest patience that a human being can have? Think about it. What's the highest patience to have? Some people will say, well, if you get really sad, you see your loved one, you know, crying, or your baby, or you see you're taking your home is destroyed, like what happened in Gaza. Or no. The highest patient is the patient of Rasulullah, Sabr Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that he went to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he met Allah, he was asked to go back. His night, he said, أبيت عند ربي يطعمني ويسقين. I spend my night with my Lord, he give me food and drink. But next day, you need to sit with this person and this woman and this girl and this, you know. Oh, Rasulullah, he hit me. He took my money. He did this to me. I'm jealous. I'm this one. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, Sayyida Hafsa brought some food for the guest. Sayyida Aisha came and he broke the food because she got jealous. He gathered me with his hand. He said, Gharat ummukum, your mother is jealous. Don't worry. He's patient. He's patient. Sabr. That he want to be with Allah all the time. And the channel is open for him. But he need to give the da'wah. He need to be patient. And so on and so on. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, sharh al-sabr. Wada' al-wizr. That means all the sins of his ummah is on his back. Allah said, I'll take care of that. And then Allah raised his status. That's when we said the Quran, A'udhu billahi shaitan rajim, bismillahir rahim, alam nashrah laka sadrak, wa wada'na anka wizrak, alladhi anqadha dhahrak, wa rafa'na laka dhikrak. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Habib Muhammad. From his characteristic, he is the most noble creation. Akram al-khalaq ala Allah. That's it. Also, the lineage to him, nasab. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullu nasabin wa sihrin. Kullu sababin wa nasabin wa sihrin. Maqtu'an yawm al-qiyama illa sababi wa nasabi wa sihri. Or kama qala Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, all the relationship or means or you know, any sabab, any reason, anything you do, or any lineage to any family, or any marriage to any family will be cut on the Day of Judgment, except if that action is connected to me, or it's a lineage to me, or somebody married to my lineage will not be cut on the Day of Judgment. So if you don't have the lineage, or you don't have married to the family of the Prophet, you have the sabab. The sabab is anything you do for Rasulullah by loving him, by reviving his sunnah, and so on. One day Sayyidina Muhammad, he went to Sayyidina Anas, Anas ibn Malik, his servant. Sayyidina Anas, he came, his mother brought him when he was 10 years old and served Rasulullah for 30 years until he is 20 years old. And then before Rasulullah died, he said, Ya Bunay, O my son. He said, if you are capable in the morning and the evening to check your heart, إِنْ قَدَرْتَ أَنْ تُصْبِحَ وَتُمْسِي وَلَيْسَ فِي قَلْبِكَ غِشْ لِأَحَدٍ مُسْلِمِينَ فَافْعَلْ. If you are capable of in the morning and the evening, you don't have any heart feeling toward any Muslim, then do that. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ سُنَّتِي. Know that this is my sunnah. وَمَنْ أَحْيَ سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي. Whoever revived my sunnah, he loves me. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever loves me, he's with me in paradise. So if you love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you'll be with him. You'll be with him in paradise. كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. That's a sabab. While Sayyidina, this is for Sayyidina Anas because he was serving and he was like in and out and so on. Sayyidina Abu Huraira took the position that he will not leave Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 1 second. 3 years. 3 years. And he is the maximum number of hadith he narrated because he stick himself to Rasulullah. It's been narrated that he flipped on earth, on the ground. People, they say, Majnoon, you're crazy. He said, Wallahi, I'm not Majnoon, but I'm hungry. Out of the hunger, he flipped on the ground, out of pain of the hunger. He does not go to seek any food because he don't want to go away from Rasulullah. So what was the advice of Rasulullah? Sure, he gave his dunya, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Sayyidina Abu Huraira. He said, Ya Aba Huraira, in aratta la tufariqana yawm al-qiyamah, hatta tukul ma'i al-jannah. If you want really to stick with me, like in this dunya, and together on the Day of Judgment, until together we enter paradise and you will not be taken away from me. What should we do? فَأَحَبَّنِي وَحُبَّا لَا تَنْسَانِي بَعْدَا. Love me, love, you don't even forget me. Just love me. Nothing else. صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد. يعني صلى الله عليه وسلم, look what he, when he was going up in the Isra, He saw angels, they're doing ruku'. All the time ruku'. He saw angels doing only sujood. All their life, sajda wahda. He saw angels standing and reciting. And all the forms that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, well, this angel, they're getting it. I need this for my own. He asked Allah for it. And Allah knew what's in his heart. Then Allah gave him the salah that we are doing a movement, maybe in 5 minutes, we're doing all the forms that all the angels are doing. That barakah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Definitely nobody was given the details of the Dajjal, you know, the false Messiah, like Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was given to his ummah to protect his ummah. Now, praying in his masjid is 1,000 times better than praying in other place. The Dajjal will not enter Mecca or Medina. It's called given to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Plague will not enter Medina. You know, Allah took it on himself to make this deen over all other religions. يُظْهِرُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. Now, and then toward the end of time, all the munafiqeen and all the bad people of Medina will be out of Medina, and all the believers will go to Medina. Now, between his pulpit and his house is Rawda. Let's talk about Rawda. Okay? So I used to sit behind that, in the back, because Rasulullah is in between this and this is Rawda. I didn't say how far to the back. So I just take a good opinion that it's all the way to whole masjid. So whatever you think of Allah, Allah will give you. His pulpit, his member on his hawd. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he said, مَوْعِدُنَا الْحَوْد. Wallahi, all of you remember this. You have appointment with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My sheikh told us once he said, once you open your eye on the day of resurrection, don't look for your parents, for your brother, your sister, your friends. Go directly to your appointment with Rasulullah on the Hawd. And Hawd is the water pool. He says, وسلم, he told everybody, he told us, you have appointment with me, with Rasulullah on the Hawd. And then Sahaba, يعني, in order for them to really understand this meaning, he told them, look, my member is on the Hawd. My member is on the Hawd. That is given to Rasulullah. He was given that all of us, we talk to him directly in our prayer. If you talk to anybody, any human being, your prayer is not valid. If you call your mom, your brother, your sister, your sheikh, any prophet, your prayer is not valid. Except Rasulullah say, Salamu alayka ayyuha nabi. It's like he's in front of me, I'm giving salam. I know people, and I heard stories of previous, I know people, I have stories of previous people, that when they said, like Sheikh Badruddin Hassan, he is known, big Sheikh in Damascus, but he died like 100 years ago. But my, you know, my father, my shiuch, they said, talk about, he will say, he'll tell people, Yaba, when you say, Salaamu Alaikum, do you hear back the Salaam from Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Said, no. He said, Wallahi, every time I say this, I hear back, wa alayka salam ya waladi. And salam on you, my son, because he's from the family prophet. So some people, they see this, they hear it. Inshallah, all of us, one day will hear it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he talked about the parts of Rasulullah, his face, his heart, his sadr, his back, his hand. If you go in the Quran, you have all of this. You know, one by one, one by one. يَدُ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ أَيْدِيهِ مَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْ رَمَيْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ. You didn't throw in your hand. It said, Allah is the one. So it's mentioned everything. قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلِّبُ وَجْهَكَ. I see your face going, you know, left and right. Go in the Quran, see how every Rasul is mentioned. You know, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكُ وَيُجْنَسِ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ. Allah brought the Qur'an on your heart. The mountain couldn't handle the Qur'an. Only the heart of Allah, the whole creation can have the Qur'an. And then filter it down to his tongue so we can, otherwise we will be all destroyed. If not coming directly to us, we'll vanish. But Allah put it on his heart. Now, it's time for this. Let me stop for soon. Also, he was given that in a dream, in a ru'ya, shaitan cannot take a form of Rasulullah. So anybody sees Rasulullah and he knew that that's Rasulullah or somebody who claimed Rasulullah or somebody said, I'm Rasulullah, it's real, it's haqq. Nobody, not at all. And most people, when they see it first time, when they wake up, shaitan will come and tell them, no, that's not Rasulullah. Try to, you know, lie on him. Now. And then Rasulullah was given from Allah, Allah told him that Allah protects you from human beings. So he used to have guards. And when Allah revealed, Wallahu ya'asimuka minan nas, Allah protects you from human beings, he went out to all the guards and said, I don't need you. Go to your home. Allah khalas, I have my protection from Allah. Allah made his sweat. And anything that comes from Allah is the best thing. From the smell, from everything you think about it. The Sahabiya, I think Umm Iman or one of Sahabiya, she, when Rasulullah was asleep, there is a sweat coming, she will put take some of the sweat. Rasulullah wake up and said, what are you doing? He said, Ya Rasulullah, we made our perfume, a good perfume with your sweat. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And then his hand, his touch, there isn't anything soft like his hand. His smell, there is nothing smell like his smell. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was given that if he pray on sitting, it's like he's praying on standing. Doesn't matter. Allah gave him this. Zakat and sadaqah, he and his family cannot get. Because this is the zakat, this is the dirty of human being, you know, wealth. It's not given to him. He was given shahada, he died as a shaheed from the poison that he got. So it was on the day of his death, that poison worked and he's shaheed. He's the only one who prayed after Asr. We're not allowed to pray after Asr because he missed Sunnah before Asr and then he did the Sunnah after Asr. Rasulullah, whenever he did something, he would keep doing it. So he kept on doing, you know, this after Asr, but we are not allowed to do this. There is a lot of other things, inshallah, I'll not go through it, but I think there is another 20 or 30. Oh, he hears things that we don't cannot hear. He said, "Inni ara ma la tarawn wa asma' ma la tasma'un." I see what you don't see. And I hear what I don't hear. You know, there is, I don't know who knows the stars that, Abu Sayyid Ali, remember the name. People, they see two or three stars in the, you know, Thuraya, I think. They say there is seven or more. Most of them will see all the stars that nobody can see. And he see from distance, like seeing from, you know, from in front of him. Now, Allah made all his Sahaba just, udul. Allah made it. Allah chose the best heart after prophets to be the heart of his companions, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, he's the only one who have two qibla, Bayt al-Maqdis and, you know, Mecca. And actually, there's people who prayed two rak'ah to Jerusalem and two rak'ah to Mecca in the same farad, subhanAllah. Also, Rasulullah, he will not lose his wudu if he sleep, deep sleeping. That's all characteristics of Rasulullah. Allah split the moon for him. The highest of all of this is إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله كل خير. Is there any questions, any comments, anything you like to say? بسم الله. Forgive me, Sidi Ali. Sidi Ali should be here and he's giving the lecture here. But, yeah, I mean, خلاص, this is end of time. Anybody have anything? Because we're going to do Salat al-Sabih. So should we take like 5 minutes? I see there's no questions. Go ahead.
Alhamdulillah.
In the fard, you are not allowed only to say Subhan Rabbil A'la, Subhan Rabbil A'zim, and you can say it odd, either 3, 5, you can do any number, but 3, 5, 7, and so on. Outside, you know, the best is to do this tasbih, but if you want to do dua, because the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in sujood, so you can do in sujood dua. In ruku' you don't do, you just do Subhan Rabbil A'zim. That's it. Nafila, you do anything in sujood. In ruku', you just do this. Now, any other question? Yes. You cannot make, according to Ahnafi, that's what I know, you cannot do dua. You do dua after tashahud. After you say, before doing salam, you are recommended to do dua actually. Yeah, in fard. Not the jinn, the question is with the heart taking away the port of, or the portion of the devil, the shaitan, the iblis. Allah ordered angel to take it away from the heart of Allah. Before that, his birth was mercy for everybody, you know. But that one was taken away. يعني he is رحمة للعالمين, just having رحمة to everybody around you. I'll give you example. He said, now we are here in Ramadan and people doing i'tikaf and so on. There is a hadith, amazing hadith. He said, if you walk to help one of your brother or sister, من مشى في حاجة أخيه is better than doing i'tikaf 10 years. Can you imagine this? In another hadith, it said, if you go to help your brother, it's better than doing 1 month's i'tikaf in my masjid, in the masjid of Rasulullah, in masjid al-Nabawi. So, no. And the best thing is actually read about his characteristic and see the way he did things and try to imitate that. And Allah Allah. Inshallah, we'll have break five minutes and we'll do Salat al-Sabih. There's Fatiha to al-Habib al-Azam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah will give us the barakah of Rasulullah in our hearts, inshallah.